Hello viewers, welcome to Elimu TV, whereby we are going to interact and also learn together. We are going to have our biology form 3, lesson 4, whereby your tutor will be Mr. Gerald. We are going to handle the topic on classification 2 under the subtopic division spermatophyta. Remember, we are this spermatophyta is falling under the kingdom plantae, but now it is we are going to handle on division spermatophyta. But before we get into the lesson, we have the lesson goals, whereby by the end of the lesson, you should be able to give the general characteristics of both the angiosperms and the gymnosperms. Welcome. This division spermatophyta, we are going to give the general characteristics, whereby the first general characteristic, we are saying that the plant is differentiated into different parts. So the plant is divided into different parts, whereby the parts may include the roots, the stems, leaves, and the seed-bearing structures. The second characteristic is that the vascular tissue is highly developed with xylem tissues consisting of both the xylem vessels and the tracheids. We have got another characteristic is that sexual reproduction is well defined. Fertilization is preceded by growth of pollen tube and does not depend on water like in other groups. We can have another characteristic that seeds are produced after fertilization. Another characteristic is that they have alternation of generations, whereby the sporophyte is the dominant generation and the gametophyte is greatly reduced and enclosed within the sporophyte. Our last but not the least characteristics is that they contain chlorophyll and are photosynthetic. This division spermatophyta is divided into two, whereby we have the gymnospermaphyta and the angiospermaphyta. So now I'd like us to look at the gymnospermaphyta, whereby the gymnospermaphyta has got its own characteristics, whereby the first characteristic is you absorbing the male cone and the female cone. In the gymnospermaphyta, we are going to look at class conivarels, whereby this class conivarels, remember the gymnospermaphyta actually is divided into three main classes. We have the conivarels, the cicadels, and the gingles. We are going to look at that one later in our lesson. But before that, let us look at the general characteristics of the gymnosperms. One, they bear cones of two types, that is the male cones and the female cones. That one is represented on our screens in the diagram. Two, after fertilization, seeds are born on the on female cones and the seeds are not enclosed in a fruit wall. Three, they show some xerophytic characteristics, such as rod, leaf, as you can see from our diagram. Also, the leaves, they are needle-like, they have got sanguine stomata. Four, that is the fourth characteristic, is that the xylem consists of mainly tracheids, while the phloem does not have companion cells. Having done and said that, remember you have said that the gymnospermaphyta is divided into three main classes, whereby we have the conivarels, we have the cicadels, and the gingles. Now I would like us to start with the first one, which is the conivarels. These include all the common gymnosperms. Coniferous trees are naturally found in areas of little water. They have small needle-shaped leaves with a thick waxy cuticle. Conifers can be recognized by the presence of cones, and most of them are evergreen. As you can see from our screen, these are the cones that we are speaking of. In the pinus, the male cones are usually small and form clusters around the base of the terminal buds. As you can see from our diagrammatic representation of the female cone. Female cones, on the other hand, appear on lateral buds on young shoots. Male cones usually are very small. Mature naked seeds occur at bases of female cones some months after pollination. Cone formation will be seen at altitudes which is approximately around 2000 meters or at higher altitudes. Although coniferous trees are common in the country, a country like Kenya is not actually, they don't do well in Kenya. So normally countries like Kenya just import them. We are going to look at our second class, which is class the cicadels. as you can see from our diagrammatic presentation, now I'm going to give you the general characteristics of the cicadels, whereby we later discuss something on them. The cicadels resemble the palms superficially. They have long compound leaves which are clustered at the apex of a thick, usually short and unbranched stems. They have cones which are borne at the apex of the trunk among the leaves. We're going to look at our the last class of that kingdom, whereby that division, sorry, whereby we have the class Gingkols. Members of this class, they are very rare. Actually, the only surviving examples of are the Gingko biloba, which is in our diagram, which is on our screen. Actually their origin is China. They are deciduous, thin, fan-like leaves. Having done and said that, we can have the following activity, whereby you should give five characteristics of members of this division Spermatophyta. For more information on this lesson, you can refer to KLB Secondary Biology Students Book 3, Nairobi, which is that is Kenya Literature Bureau. And also, to get this lesson and many more of our biology lessons, you can send us an SMS to the number that is appearing on our screen, or you subscribe to either our YouTube or Facebook page, which are both Elimu TV, or you tweet us at Elimu_TV_Kenya. Let us subscribe to enjoy many more of our lessons. Thank you.